to soy milk. And Michael's also running at 10 feet per second. And we know Michael starts out at 0, 0 and is going to the point 200, 300, where parameterize in motion x is going to equal a plus bt, and y is going to equal c plus dt. Better calculate time it takes for Michael to get to his soy milk. So make this right triangle. And we say, well, the distance Michael travels in this direction is 200. And the distance Michael travels in this direction is 300. This distance is 300. So if we call that d, then we can say the distance equals the square root 300 squared plus 200 squared. Which equals the square root 9, 1, 2, 3, 4 plus 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Square root of 13, 1, 2, 3, 4. And the square root of 130,000 is approximately 360.5551 feet. And we know the distance equals rate times time, so 360.5551 feet equals 10 feet per second times time divided by 10. Where the time is approximately 36.0555 seconds. Michael will get from point A to point B. So Michael's initial x coordinate is 0, his new x coordinate is 200, he'll reach that x coordinate 200 starting at initial exponent is 0. We don't know how quickly that exponent is changing, but we know that he's going to make it change in 36.0555 seconds. So put the 0 across 200 equals b times 36.0555 divided by 36.0555. We get a b value approximately 5, 4, 7, 0. So we parameterized Michael's x coordinate. His x coordinate will always be approximately 0 plus 5.5470 t. We'll parameterize his y coordinate. His new y coordinate is 300. Starts out with y coordinate 0. We don't know how quickly that y coordinate is changing with respect to time, but we know that the time it's going to take changes 36.0555 seconds. So let's treat 0 from both sides. And then 36.0555. And get a d value of approximately 300 divided by 36.0555. D value of approximately 8.320. So his y coordinate will always be at 0 plus 8.3205t. So we have Michael's parameterization, continuous parameterization. So now we want to write a distance formula that connects these two parameterizations together. And we'll do that here. And say the distance between these two individuals using our distance formula. Oops, I want that. Is going to be 400 minus 8.9443t minus 5.5470t the squared plus 50 plus 4.4721t minus 8.3205t the squared, which is the square root of 400 minus 8.9443 minus 5.547 minus 3.3973 t equal to square plus 50. This is going to be minus, so we have 4.4721 minus 8.3205. Minus 3.8484t squared. At this point, we're going to square both sides. So I should really have this as d of t. Let me fix that. So d of t equals this. And it'll be d of t equals this. And now what I want to do is I want to get rid of the square root. So I'm actually going to have the distance squared using t as an input. Equals 400 minus 3.3973 t pi squared plus 50 minus 3.8484 t pi squared. Now I want to do this expansion. So we have 400 times 400 is 1600, and then double these two. So 3.3973 times 400 times 2. Be negative 2717.84t. And we square that last one to 3.3973 times 3.3973. So plus 11.5416t squared plus 2500. Double those two. 15 times 2, 50 times 100. Maybe minus 384.84. It's an error here, sure. 0, 0, t. Rounded that number. And then I've got 3.8484 times 3.8484 minus plus 14. 8102t squared. I'll collect all my terms. Then I've got my t squareds plus 11.5416. It's 26.3518t squared. I'll collect my t terms, so I have negative 27.17.84 minus 384.84. So I should have 27.17.84 minus 3102.68t. 2,500, 3,600, it's just, what does it matter? It's going to be 4,100. Because I said it doesn't matter because we're used to going to find the x and y coordinate of the vertex of this quadratic. I'm going to do negative b over 2a. So we have 310 divided by 2 divided by 26.3518. And so we're going to get a t value, excuse me, the x coordinate of the vertex is going to be 5.88 on t value. and then defining the distance they are away at that time. We have to plug that value back into our distance formula. Make sure you don't plug it into this one. This is the distance squared, but we can definitely plug it into this formula. So we'll do that. We'll do the distance using 5.881 equals square root 400 23.3973 times 5.8819 squared plus 50 23.8484 times 5.8819 squared. So if I go through this, I can make a arithmetic error here. So my iPhone calculator, so that's square root 5.8819 squared times negative 3.3. Oh, I'm in the second there. 4.8 squared. So I need to do negative 3.3973 times 5.8819. I get the square root of 143.2404 plus 83.84 times 5.88. 50 squared. Square root 145,225.1718. And the square root of that number is 381.0842.